I've told you a little bit about this piece already. Johan de Meij is one of the most prolific and important wind composers and conductors, really, too, but composers in the world. He's originally from Amsterdam. That's where he had all his training, and he began really composing. The first piece that he did that really put him on the map was his Lord of the Rings Symphony, long before the movie. And he wrote this wonderful piece, and I remember Larry Harper at Carroll College. We get together every year. We graduated with our doctorates together. He just retired from Carroll College in Waukesha. And we get together and talk about repertoire every year, and he goes, Reg, he says, you won't believe this piece. Wait until you play. He says, the good news is you're going to love this symphony, and the bad news is you're never going to be able to get it. Well, I love those kind of challenges, and I heard that five-movement symphony is like, oh, wow. So it took me a good month to connect with him. This is back in the days when it was a little harder to do. This is back in the late 80s when it was a lot harder to connect with composers from other countries. And but I finally got a hold of him, and he sent me the music, and we did this wonderful symphony. We did the United States premiere that I believe in 1990-something. Well, he wrote a lot of pieces since then. And so when we were going to South Africa, I thought we really need a piece of music that represents, to give back, that represents their culture, and to give back to those people as sort of a gift, so that they would recognize, the audience would recognize, we'll bring them American music, but we'd like to give them something that's of their own music. And over those last years that I was there to present at Lutheran education conferences, I made it a point to collect folk songs. Well, Johan did the same thing through friends he had there, and he finally chose the folk songs that are used in this piece. This particular piece, African Harmony Songs for Mama Africa, can be played two ways. One, and if you buy our CD, the track two is just straight instruments. Just straight instruments, no choir. Track nine is exactly the same thing, only with choir singing in Zulu. Singing in Zulu. Now, they didn't have time to learn the whole piece in Zulu, but they are going to sing with us a little bit. Sometimes it's going to be a little hard to sing. I think we have a mic back there, so maybe you might be able to hear them. And they have a wonderful, I'm glad. It'd be done either way, but they do such a great job. They work so hard on it there in the back there. We want to make sure that you can hear them at least a little bit, if not a lot. Some of the places they're not going to be singing, but a lot of places they are. And then you have a wonderful soloist to sing the lullaby in the middle. It's about a 12-minute piece, and we're going to take you sort of on a tour through the cultures of Africa, and because some of these are also known to other countries on the continent of Africa as well. And I just want to tell you one thing that just happened, and that this particular piece won in the top three in the world, in a world composition contest. My wife and I were in Utrecht, I guess they say it, Utrecht, the Netherlands, when this was announced back in July. And the composer was with us as well, so this piece is really being performed all over the world now. And we hope you enjoy African Harmony, Songs from Mama Africa, by Johan de Meij, with both the wind symphony and the choir.